In this tutorial, you will see how to perform a semi-finishing operation and edit leads and links after the toolpath has been created. The final section of this tutorial is to produce an NC program. For this tutorial, we will require a new ball nose tool. In the tool database, we can search by tool type. Select ball nose as the type and search. Select the 16mm ball nose and press Create Tools. Close the database. You may want to reuse tools in other projects and their associated holders. We can add tools to our database by right-clicking on the tool and saying Add to Database. Update the database if prompted to do so. Note we are adding a tool and its holder. The holder from our end mill can now be applied to our ball nose tool. Making sure the ball nose tool is active, select the holder database icon. Apply the holder and close the form. Edit the tool and adjust the holder overhang to be 60mm. We now need the toolpath. From the toolpath creation dialog, select the finishing section and choose a steep and shallow toolpath. A steep and shallow toolpath is a combination toolpath, which splits the model into steep angled areas and shallow angled areas, automatically applying two different toolpath types to those regions. For this part, a constant Z toolpath is used for the steep areas, and we will be using a 3D offset toolpath for the shallow areas. Name the toolpath semi-finish. We will then set the step down to be calculated using the cusp, with a cusp height of 0.1mm. The step over will be set to 2mm. Since this is a semi-finishing toolpath, we will also leave 0.5mm of thickness on the part. Hit Calculate to generate the toolpath. Toolpaths will inherit some of the settings from the previously active toolpath. In this case, leads and links of the semi-finishing toolpath have been inherited from the roughing operations. From the Toolpath Edit tab, select the Toolpath Connections button to edit the leads and links. Under the Lead In tab, choose a surface normal arc and set the angle of 90 degrees and a radius of 8mm. Copy these settings to the lead out also. In the Links tab, change the first choice to be a circular arc and increase the distance to 50mm to set the maximum distance over which this type of link will happen. By selecting Apply and Accept, the leads and links will be modified. Note that the toolpath did not require any recalculation. This toolpath can also be added to the stock model, and we can recalculate it. Hiding the model, block, and toolpath reveals the stock model state after the semi-finishing. The final section of this tutorial is to produce an NC program. To output NC code, you will require the Autodesk Manufacturing Post-Processor utility installed. From either the Explorer tree or the NC Program tab in the ribbon, create an NC program. Change the name to 0001. For the option file, browse to the Manufacturing Post-Processor Utility folder in the Public Documents area and select a post-processor from the Generic folder. In this case, we will select a FANUC post-processor. Accept the form. The toolpaths can be added to the NC program in many ways, either via the ribbon, the context-sensitive right-click menu, or by simply dragging and dropping. Once all three toolpaths have been added, a summary list shows the major toolpath settings. The NC program can be written by pressing the right button. To see the NC program, select the View File option. The part is now ready for some finishing toolpaths. Save the project to complete this tutorial.